We're here at the Clark Oval here with Chris Hollywood-Wilson on the back of the under-18s interleague match against the Ballarat Footy League. Tough night tonight, mate.
Very tough night. Very tough night, yeah, it's the same blues.
Now, a very good first quarter from you guys. There wasn't too much in it, and in terms of the turnovers and such and the tackles, quite pleasing.
Yeah, really pleasing. The first quarter was great. We had a real focus on our pressure football and our tackling. We actually out-tackled him. The only problem with that was that our turnovers were also up. So whilst we're winning a lot of the hard ball and cracking in, we're giving it straight back. So that sort of leveled out.
What did you sort of say to the boys at quarter time and sort of some of the players in particular that needed a lift?
Yeah, look, I just asked them to perform what they've done at training and get back to, you know, the basic things that we've been working on. And unfortunately, the Ballarat boys are, you know, they're a really slick unit, and absolute credit to their coach. They do a fantastic job. You know, they run. They were just able to take us on, run, change direction, and really drive. And unfortunately, our guys were too reactive on the night.
Now, in the second quarter, they came out and kicked 6-1, and almost the first quarter work was almost undone.
Yeah, it was. You know, from that moment on, you know, halfway through the second quarter, we were really behind the eight ball. And, you know, I kept asking the boys just get back to basics and do the little things well. And when they started to do that, they showed, you know, really good glimpses of being able to transition the ball out the other side and work it down the flanks. You know, unfortunately, we fell down a little bit across half forward, so that was.
7 goals down at half time. What did you say to the boys on the back of that second quarter fade out?
Yeah, look, you know, it was difficult because once the boys start to look at a deficit like that, you know, they start to question themselves. And I just told them that, you know, look, everyone's in there playing for their spots. And, you know, but at the same time, I said, you know, okay, we're doing some little things well. So I just tried to reinforce that to see if we can, you know, get a reaction out of that. Unfortunately, the reaction wasn't fully there, but, you know, some of them showed glimpses, which was good.
Well, I noticed you guys started the third term quite well, a few good goal-scoring opportunities. Probably could have made a little bit better. I know there's a couple of shots within close range that could have gone through. Obviously, wouldn't have made too much deficit on the scoreboard, but enough to give a little bit of confidence. If those goals had gone through, perhaps it could have changed the game a bit.
Oh, absolutely. Everybody knows it. Scoreboard pressure is what, you know, can change a game of football. So, you know, whether you're 5 goals down or 10 goals down, you know, we see it at AFL level and at club level every week. If you know, you kick one becomes two becomes three, and the momentum changes. So whilst you may not actually win the game, you can get back into the game and, you know, you can save a bit of face. We weren't able to do that.
Bit disappointing in the last term not to get a score on the board, and they end up kicking about 4 or so goals. Did they sort of just let their heads drop a bit?
Yeah, I think they did. We only had the one inside 50, and it went in there by accident, pretty much. You know, it was the opposition that took it in there, and it just goes to show how dominant they were across halfback. You know, that really hurt. The fact that we didn't hit the scoreboard at all is really concerning. However, we had a lot of the 17-year-olds in the squad. You know, so we've got, you know, 6 or 7 to come straight back in, and maybe a couple others. So, you know, next week against Alberton in another 10 days, you're going to see an entirely different squad. So, you know, your flanks become pockets now, and, you know, these sorts of things. So key positions head out to wings and stuff like that. So, you know, we're not down now.
Well, with the Ballarat team you guys face tonight, very good quality opposition anyway, year in, year out. So while that isn't all doom and gloom, it still gives you plenty to work with and a bit more confidence heading into to the May 24 clutch.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, for us, you know, being a sister league, you know, it's you know, they're the benchmark, and that's what we want to set ourselves for. I think it was mentioned that they had about 5 or 6 TAC listed players. We had access to a couple, but we chose not to take them in. And, you know, their class stood out, so full credit to them. They were really good.
Best players tonight, a bit hard considering the margin. And Morrissey, the best for you guys?
Yeah, he was great. You know, he started off forward and deep, and, you know, he presented for us as well. And then when we had a bit of a mismatch at centre half back, well, I switched him back there, and I thought he did a really good job. So, you know, full credit to him, he was really good. I thought Brandon Watts from the Summer Kangaroos was sensational. And we iced him up early because we want to take him into the next game. There's a couple others too. So as our rotations were going through, you know, we sort of had a few downfalls. So I guess that comes back to me. That's what I'll work with.
We had some good quality coaching staff behind you, and I guess a bit more hunger going into the Alberton clash.
Yeah. We definitely had our priorities set for that game. We're using this as a step up. That's fine. We've learned a lot about our squad tonight, and we've learned a lot about ourselves and the way we're structured. So, you know, and we've seen tonight firsthand what the next elite level is. So, you know, it's something for us to work for, and, you know, if we haven't got something to work for, then we're going to become complacent. So, you know, in a way, I'm glad that, we got to witness what we did tonight, because, you know, only good things can come forward.
Well, thanks so much for joining us here on the Other Footy Show this week, mate. And obviously not on the best note, but obviously working hard for the big clash, which is the one you're working for anyway.
Absolutely. Thanks, Adam.
Thanks for joining us.